Hallo und willkommen zurück hier in der großen Halle 10.1 bei unserem fantastischen Rocket Beans Stand. Rocket Beans! Yeah, they're very enthusiastic. Ja. Hi Zach, wir haben Zach hier und Tobias und ihr zeigt uns beide heute, you're showing us a game that is very deep buried in my heart. It's Life is Strange, the prequel before the storm, and we're gonna hear about what happened before, what happened between Rachel and Chloe and Rachel. So yeah. I'm really excited. You got a 15-minute presentation.
Yeah, we're gonna show you one of the levels early on in the game.
Okay, but first of all, we have to make one point clear. You made that clear to me. You are not the team that developed the original.
That's
so
right.
So you get
yeah.
that a lot, I guess. Yeah. Everyone is talking about that.
That's right. Yeah. So the first Life is Strange was developed by Dontnod, amazing developer, and they made an amazing game. Before the Storm is a prequel that's been developed by Deck Nine Games, my studio, in conjunction with the core team at Square Enix that worked on the first one.
The first question, why? I mean, it's not unusual, but why are you developing a prequel?
Yeah, it's a good question. It's the fans that loved the characters and the world of Arcadia Bay from the first game. And Square is really just responding to the demand in the community to kind of go back to that space and see those characters and experience that story again.
Yeah, it's like a good TV show. You wanna you got to know the characters. You wanna spend more time with them.
Right.
So I'm really looking forward to that. One question: what about supernatural elements of the original? I mean, because of it's a different story with different people, and they don't have that kind of power. So it's quite interesting how you got around that.
Yeah, so the first Life is Strange centered on Max Caulfield, who had this incredible ability to rewind time. And that was really that was really fun, and it was a perfect power for Max's character, for her personality. She's the kind of person who would second-guess her choices, who would want to make sure that everything she was doing was right. For Before the Storm, we're going back in time a few years before the events of the first game, and we're asking players to step into the shoes of Chloe Price, who's this kind of wrecking ball character, not like Max. She doesn't care about rewinding.
She's trouble.
Yeah, she is trouble. So we looked at what it would be like to play as Chloe, and the ability to rewind time from a canon standpoint wouldn't fit with the story and what we know from what happened in the first game. But even just from a character standpoint, Chloe's not the kind of person who's going to second guess what she does. She's going to make a choice, and she's going to live with the consequences.
You're going to show us a little bit about that, and I'm pretty sure you will keep talking while we're playing. So let's start the game and, well, get a look at the first scenes of Before the Storm.
Awesome.
So how far are you in the game? Are you done yet with that?
So the first episode is releasing next week, August 31st.
Okay, so that one is covered.
Oh, yeah. Xbox One, PlayStation 4, PC. Yeah. We're really excited. Oh. Yeah.
This is intense. Shit.
Hey, Delia, come.
You died.
So what we're looking at here, is a scene called The Mill. It's an abandoned lumberyard on the edge of Arcadia Bay. 16-year-old Chloe has just fought her way inside because she wants to see a band that's playing here.
How hard is it to get into the mindset of an angsty teenager in that kind of situation?
Well, I think Chloe's pretty unique, but I think we've all been, well, if you're an adult, you've been 16, you've been alienated, and you've probably wanted to go to a place like this at some point in your life.
What's her name?
Delia. She doesn't usually like people.
Me neither.
So we see the gameplay is same as usual. You can walk around and contact with nearly everything.
That's right.
Do you still have thoughtful moments where you just sit down and let everything pass in your head and monologues happening?
We call them Zen moments. Chances for the player to just take their time.
Yeah, I really like that. Yeah. Not a lot of games allow their players to just, you know, let it go for a minute.
That's right. So Chloe tried to get a t-shirt for the band, and this t-shirt vendor basically told her it's $20. He doesn't have any money, so she's pretty pissed off at him.
That's exactly what we need.
She's gonna figure out another way to get the t-shirt that she wants.
Releasing that brake would roll the car right out from under that tool. Do I want a firewalk shirt that bad? I think I do.
Yeah, but you never know what's gonna happen.
Well, what do you think we should do? Do you want to release the brake?
And run over some young teenagers? Why not?
Yeah.
Give it a try. I'm pretty sure something bad will happen.
Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
But 20, I mean, $20 is okay for a shirt. Rocket Bean shirt are $20 as well. It's a good price.
I don't know, when you're 16, $20 is a lot.
Yeah, but why does she want a t-shirt anyway? I mean, she doesn't strike me as the kind of band
Thanks
t-shirt
for
girl.
Dick.
I guess buy all that band. Merchandise?
I guess it depends on the band.
Yeah, okay.
Sweet victory.
Kurzer Hinweis an euch zu Hause, wenn ihr Fragen habt, ich bin jetzt im Twitch-Chat und gerne gebe ich die Fragen an Zach weiter. Also einfach reinschreiben und dann gebe ich das weiter. Okay, steal the money!
Yeah,
steal
right.
the money and run!
Wow, you want to do that right
yeah,
now?
Yeah, I do yeah. that all
okay.
the time.
So one thing that was true of the first game, it's all about choices and consequences.
Holy
There's no
shit.
Necessarily right or wrong path to the game. You can't fail. You're going to make the choices that you want, and you're going to have to deal with the consequences of those
yeah.
choices. So you
Say,
just stole we'll, $20. Or
I mean, if you know
bucks.
The original, they will come back to haunt you somehow.
Absolutely. So check these guys out. Some new characters. We're also going to see some familiar faces.
Oh, like, that's an interesting question. How many fan service is in the game? Because, I mean, Max, the main protagonist, isn't in the game, so how did you try to get the look and feel of the original
oh,
for the fans?
I mean, very carefully. We were huge fans of the first Life is Strange, rebuilding that world and that beautiful art style.
But you want to tell your own story, I guess. I
Absolutely.
Mean, you have your own problem, too.
Yeah.
Hey!
So you might recognize this guy. It's Frank Bowers.
Ah.
You bought pot from me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
So you can
XXX, I know our
yeah.
audience.
Okay.
They're probably baked right now.
Definitely use something. Take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the $175 you owe me.
So because you stole the money before, you have an opportunity now where you could buy weed from Frank. You don't have to.
Why not buy illegal stuff with money you stole? I mean, it fits perfectly.
Let's do it.
Just get rid of it fast.
Hey, what are you waving around with this kind of money?
Now, if you chose not to do that, you walk out of the scene with $200 in your pocket, which maybe you could spend elsewhere. Instead, you're going to walk out of the scene with a bag of weed.
No more loans.
I'm kind of a bad influence for the game. Huh? That's maybe the darkest path
yeah.
you could take.
Yeah.
And it took me 3 minutes.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's telling you a lot about yourself. That's okay.
Yeah, definitely. But it's Chloe. I mean, that's how I remember her. So these two are going to be an item now. They're going to be friends, right?
Maybe.
I guess there was something between them, right? They were having sex or anything like that?
Not
your, those they're two. Just friends?
Yes. So
sure.
Chloe and Frank have a history.
Yeah.
Basically, she buys weed from him and then occasionally owes him money. So there's another system we're going to look at in a second. Max had photography in the first game. She would take pictures
yeah.
of things, right? That's kind of a passive collectible mode. With Chloe, she likes to put her mark on the world. So we developed a graffiti system. It's the alternative to photography.
That's a nice touch. I mean, it fits her.
And you can choose what you want to put on the
You
software.
Can leave your mark in the game.
Yeah.
That's neat. Oh, I got one question from the chat. When will the episodes be released? I mean, which kind of, how many months between
them? Yeah, so episode one comes out August 31st on Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and PC. Episodes 2 and 3 will be coming out over the next 4 months, roughly. We haven't announced release dates yet.
Oh, but you don't have exact dates.
That's right.
So you just hope you get it done.
Yeah. So let's see about getting in to see the band.
So the first game was kind, of course it was a sci-fi set, no, it was a sci-fi idea with all the time manipulation and stuff, but it also was about bullying,
sure.
Right? So is that kind of a topic as well in the sequel, or is it really going some different place?
Yeah.
I mean, because Chloe isn't the one who gets bullied, I guess.
Probably not.
She's more the one who bullies.
That's right. Okay, well, I'm going to answer that in a second. We bumped into this gentleman, and he spilled his beer on himself.
Don't blow him off.
You don't want to blow, you don't
no,
blow him off?
No, I would never blow him off.
Let's
apologize.
Let's apologize.
My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope. Don't care, either.
And let me know how that works out for you. Bitch.
So you pointed out that the first game had sci-fi elements, but it was also about bullying. And they covered a lot of really human issues, social issues, personal issues, depression. You had Kate, potential suicide.
Yeah.
And that's kind of a foundational cornerstone of the franchise, is a willingness to look at these very real-world social issues. And we've embraced that same philosophy with Before the Storm. So now Chloe's sneaking upstairs. She's hoping she's going to get a better view of the band.
Yes! Finally made it! I can't believe it!
She's a girl, so it's hard to choose. He looks like the guy who would deny her a girl pass, if you know what I mean. So he might hit her, so I would apologize or walk away. I mean,
let's try one of those.
If I would be playing The Rock, I would, of course, insult him or kick his ass. But yeah, you see?
Yeah, it's no good. What do you think Chloe
Grab
would
your
do?
Gun. You don't have a gun? She has no gun. What kind of teenager is that? Okay, apologize, of course. You have to try everything.
I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good.
Okay. Okay, you have to
One choice
him.
Left.
That's all that works on me. Oh, there's a butterfly from the butterfly effect coming.
Wow.
Nice. She tried everything. I mean, she apologized. Ah, okay. Of course, and now I would attack. I mean, it's getting quite dangerous, and he's like on the first floor, so maybe you can push him right down. He breaks his neck and is dead instantly. So I would try that.
Yeah, let's attack.
That's what
let's
I hope for. Oh, of course.
There we go.
Between the legs.
Oof.
But no one falls. That's nice.
Rachel?
Okay, that's how they met.
Hurry up.
Okay, I guess that was your presentation, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It looks exactly like I want it to look. I mean, it looks familiar. It looks like a game with characters I already know and want to know more of.
Right.
I'm really excited about the story. I mean, what you're going to do, what kind of, you told us, supernatural elements will there be? What kind of manipulation of the game will be possible? I'm pretty sure you will have some dark secrets of characters we already know that. I mean, that's one question. You had a very clear antagonist in the original, but now, I mean, you can do that again. So what are you, without spoiling too much, could you give us like a clue what it's all about?
Yeah, absolutely. So we're looking at Chloe's life when she's 16, several years before the first game. It's 2 years since her father died. And Max left. So Max moved away to Seattle.
She's maybe in a quite problematic place.
She's in a bad place. Yeah. She's struggling with grief over her father. Joyce, her mother, is moving on. She's dating this new guy named David, who we might know from the first game. Chloe's having a hard time at school, at home. She's alienated. She's alone, and she's really angry. And we're looking at this moment when she meets Rachel Amber. It's this mythic character from the first game.
Yeah.
Everybody in the first game had something to say about Rachel.
And you never got to meet her.
But you never got to meet her face to face. So this story explores what that meeting was like for Chloe and for Rachel, and the kind of explosive impact Rachel had on Chloe's life.
I mean, she changed Chloe quite a bit. I mean, she looks different in the original, so something has to be happened. And I think we're going to live through that in the
Absolutely,
game.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay. Whoa, three episodes, not four or five?
Three episodes, that's right.
Okay. I'm really looking forward. So what's going on with the whole franchise, the expanded universe? I mean, of course, you can talk about everything, but maybe you can give us an overview about stuff that's coming.
Sure, yeah. So I can say Don't Nod's in development on Life is Strange 2. They made that announcement, I think it was back in May of this year. We're completing Before the Storm right now. And this is really a Square responding to the community that sprung up around the first game and how much passion and love that there is for these characters in this world. And we're all really excited to see where Life is Strange is going to go next.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it will work for a TV series on Netflix or whatever as well. It's pretty good source material. And it's... I mean, it would be better than, I don't know, 13 Reasons Why, which is a series I watched recently. It's okay, it's nice, but it doesn't hit, you know, it doesn't hit the point. Mm-hmm. Which is funny, because there it's all about mobbing and stuff, but in the game it's not about all that, but it works better, you know, to get the point across.
Yeah.
It's quite interesting. So if our chat has some more questions, we don't have that much time left. But maybe there are going to be some questions. Also wenn ihr jetzt noch Fragen habt, dann bitte postet die jetzt schnell in Chat, dann stelle ich die noch. Oh, that's an interesting question from Lubitsky. So, do you have the content of all the episodes already done and prepared, or would it be possible to change stuff depending on the resonance with the audience? You know, like in Breaking Bad, when they get one character, who was supposed to get killed off, and then they just put him like on the front because it was so popular.
Right. It's one of the the strengths of episodic content, but it really just depends on the schedule. So we're in full production. We've completed a certain amount of the remaining game, but we're working on more. I can't release the details at this stage, but we're really excited to hear the fans' responses August 31st, after we release episode one, and we get to experience their feedback. Sometimes there is the potential for change.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I'm looking forward for the game too. I'm going to play it for Rocket Beans, definitely. Okay, now they're asking about Pokemon and Vampire. Not the right guy.
Yeah.
Guy. So, okay, well, one more maybe personal question. How's about Ashley Birch, the director who voiced...
Yeah.
I don't know, who was it? Chloe in the first game. How's she doing?
Yeah, so Ashley Birch is the voice actress who played Chloe in the first game.
Yeah.
She did an amazing job. She is Chloe. I mean, we found out halfway through development that due to the SAG-AFTRA strike, we weren't able to use her on this project. She couldn't perform Chloe.
That said, I mean, the voice is very important, and you got to know the voice. So what are you going to do?
Eh? Yeah, it was heartbreaking. We were pretty sad about it. We sent her the script for the first episode, just to say this is what we're working on. We love the work that you did. We love Life is Strange. She read it and reached out to us, and we brought her on as a story consultant. So she, in addition to being an actress, she's a really talented writer. So she has worked with me in developing the scripts. She goes over every line of dialogue. We have conference calls. We've had her out to the studio, and we use her very unique perspective on who Chloe is to kind of help us find the nuance, the detail of what she can be in Before the Storm.
I mean, she is Chloe in a way, so it's good to have someone like her to talk with about the character.
Right.
Okay, jetzt kommen wir kurz zum Ende, wenn ihr jetzt nicht noch Fragen habt. Will Jonathan Morelli be back as composer? Of course, yeah, the soundtrack is quite important as well in the game, right? So what about that? What about the sound?
So yeah, score? So we recently announced that we partnered with an indie rock band called Daughter to compose the score for Before the Storm. They were really the perfect partner. I think their sound is simultaneously like Life is Strange, but at the same time unique in the way that Chloe is different from Max. So we love the music that we've constructed for the game. We think fans are going to love it too.
Yeah, of course it needs its own score. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Just to add to that, Daughter will be releasing that score as an album called Music from Before the Storm. That's coming out September 1st. So with the first game, a lot of people were always asking us if they could get the music on CD or as an album download. So Daughter are actually releasing the score, so the soundtrack, not the licensed soundtrack. So in this game, you heard a couple artists already, but Daughter did the instrumentals, and they're releasing that as an album. And you could actually hear Burn It Down. It played in the trailer, and you can listen to it on Spotify now as well. So it's really accessible to fans if they want to listen to that right now already.
So how anxious are you to the release? I mean, it's coming in a few days. Yeah. What do you think will people think about it? What will they write about it? What do you hope for?
I mean, I wouldn't say I'm anxious. I'm definitely excited. I think we all are at Tech Nine.
I would be anxious as shit.
Yeah. that's fair. I think I just hope that fans from the first game get to explore a new experience in Chloe's shoes at a different time in her life, and get a deeper and better understanding of who she is and why she becomes the girl that you know.
Yeah. Would you be prepared, if it's a great success, to create more sequel prequels, or is the story going to expand from from the beginning to the 2 years?
Yeah, I think it's
until the.
It's hard to say. It's hard to say what might happen to Life is Strange down the road. I think we are releasing a fourth episode, a bonus episode with our deluxe version, that is a chance to go back and play as Max and with Chloe, sort of one last time. Before Life is Strange moves on to other narratives.
Okay, that sounds interesting as well. Thank you for coming, Zach.
Thank you
for showing everything.
Yeah.
Danke an dich, Tobias, fürs Vorzocken. Wir haben leider nicht so viel Zeit, deswegen müssen wir an der Stelle dicht machen, aber viel mehr dürft ihr eh nicht zeigen. You're not allowed to show us more than the 15 minutes. I'm really sorry about that. But I'm going to play the game this week, I guess. I've heard about that, maybe not. Yeah. Also, mir wurde gesagt, ich werde es nochmal spielen können, vielleicht dann auch nur die Stelle. Dann werde ich nochmal ein bisschen mehr dazu sagen. Jetzt geben wir aber erstmal weiter an den Rest der Beanscom. Das war's. Danke und tschüss.
Tschö.
Thank you.